I'm gonna show you 7 real-life situations where you can use ChatGPT to actually get ahead of everyone else. I will share my own story where a doctor gave me the wrong diagnosis and ChatGPT saved me. How I use it to build custom travel plans that feel super personal. How it basically replaced my fitness coach and my nutrition expert. And a bunch of other cool use cases, all in this short video. Easiest example, translating some text. How not to do it? Translate this to Spanish. But if you tweak it just a bit, you will get something totally different. Translate this to Spanish like a native would say it. Or even better, translate it to Spanish like a native would, but using simple everyday words. Wanna go deeper? Translate like a super polite 62-year-old dude from Valencia would say it. So you got the idea. The more context you give, the more accurate the translation will be. So this is Coke Zero, no sugar, so it's healthier than regular Coke, right? Or is that just a big marketing trick? Yeah, there is no sugar, but it's got a sugar substitute called aspartame. Let's have ChatGPT play scientist for a sec and dig into the latest research on aspartame and just give us a straight up summary. How safe is this stuff really? You're gonna be shocked. But aspartame is not just not healthier, it's actually pretty bad for you. And yep, that's backed by real science. Meanwhile, big corporations, they're just cashing in business, nothing personal. According to studies, ChatGPT is already diagnosing more accurately than some doctors, and the price way cheaper. But you gotta know how to ask it the right way. Let me tell you a personal story. I had this bad cough, so I went to a doctor, and he said it was asthma and gave me meds. But honestly, it didn't feel like asthma, it felt more like some viral thing. So I typed out all my symptoms and what the doctor said and asked ChatGPT. And guess what? It agreed with me. It said, sounds more like acute bronchitis, not asthma. I went to another doctor and yeah, he confirmed it, not asthma, it was bronchitis. So since then, I double check everything health related with ChatGPT. So, how do you turn ChatGPT into your own virtual doctor? Describe the problem in detail. Like say, someone's got this constant itch in one specific spot on their back, right between the shoulder blades. And the doctors have no clue what's going on and all the tests come back normal. Just explain what the issue is and how to treat it. If you are doing it like that, that's not really the right way. So what is the right way? Delete that last line and instead write this. What follow-up questions could help figure out the right diagnosis? Just list the questions. Then go ahead and answer each follow-up question it might have. But if you just send it as is, ChatGPT will not want to give you a clear diagnosis. It will give you something generic and tell you to see a doctor. So what do we do? Here's the trick. We say you are the doctor and you got the patient with these symptoms and you just want a second opinion from a fellow doctor. And the result way more useful and detailed. Also remember these 4 key tips when writing your prompt. First, start with your goal. What do you actually want? Like, I want to get some tips on how to sleep better. I usually take forever to fall asleep and still wake up tired in the morning. Second, set a return format. How should it reply? Bullet points, diagnosis list. Third, add warnings. What the model should be extra careful with. And fourth, give it context. The more background, the better the result. But hey, do not treat ChatGPT like a full-on replacement for doctors. Not yet. Think of it more like a solid second opinion. I'm obsessed with travel, but planning a trip that actually fits me? Total brain workout. And those travel vloggers, they all hit the same places, same food, same selfies, and same crowds. So now I just plan everything with a ChatGPT, and honestly, total game changer. But here's the thing. Don't just say, make me a travel plan for Seoul. You will get the same basic tourist list that you have seen a million times on every SEO blog ever. Here is how to do it right. Give it context. For example, about me. I'm going to Seoul for 4 days and wanted to figure out what to do and where to stay, but I'm not into the palaces, markets, super touristy spots or old villages. I'm more curious about what modern Seoul is like, the fashion, the cool vibes, the weird little cafes, and also where can I grab some of that famous Korean skincare on sale. Tell it who you are, what you are into, what you can't stand, and your vibe. Then compare that to the basic version. It's not even close. One more tip if you love travel, search the city on TikTok. Locals post the good stuff, hidden gems, cool spots, things no blog ever mentions. Websites are old news. Oh, and I just started an Instagram. If you have watched this far, I'd love if you gave me a follow. I share AI tips and little notes from my travels. Right now I've got 14 followers and let's make it 15. And I seriously love to see you there. You know what this is? Yeah, me neither. I'm at Japanese store in Bangkok. Everything here is Japanese, super unique stuff. And all the labels either in Japanese or Thai, which I don't speak at all. Back in the day, Google Translate was my go-to. You point the camera, it gives you some kind of translation. Not perfect, but it worked. But ChatGPT, whole new level. You can just take a photo of a fridge full of mystery items and send it to ChatGPT. And it will tell you what it is, how to eat it, and what it tastes like. You can even send pics of 3 random products and ask which one is the healthiest based on ingredients. Living abroad, I'm always asking stuff like what is this, what's the nutrition information, how do people cook it, how do you even eat it? Highly recommending using it when you travel, totally lifesaver. Right now, I'm training for HYROX competition. It's a mix of running and crazy fitness challenges. Never done it before, and I've got less than a month to get ready. And yep, my coach is ChatGPT. Might actually film a full video on that soon. What do you think? So, how does it even work? Let me show you. You just give the model as much context as possible. Who you are, what you do, how much you weigh, what your goals are, and in my case, express prep for HYROX. Then I ask ChatGPT to build me a full 1 month workout plan in a clear, easy to follow format. And it gave me a super clean workout table. But let's be real, workouts mean nothing without proper nutrition. So I asked for a custom meal plan, like one a real nutritionist would make. Told it I'm prepping for HYROX and also trying to drop a little weight. And last thing, someone's gotta hype us up and keep us going, right? So I set up a little chat with a ChatGPT that acts like a personal coach. You drop in your workout results, how you ate, what you're feeling, and it replies. Tells you if you're on track, explains why you might feel exhausted today, and of course sends you some motivation vibes. Drop a comment and let me know how you use ChatGPT to make life easier.